Hello, class. Unfortunately, I cannot be with you today. However, we have a great substitute that's going to be helping us out. Today, we're going to watch a movie called Peter and the Wolf. What's really cool about this movie is that every one of the characters in the movie is represented by a musical instrument. That's why we're going to watch it in music class. The substitute is going to pass out a worksheet to you that's going to help us follow along. Now, it's very important you know what to do, so I'm going to tell you. First of all, make sure you put your name up at the top of the worksheet where it says name. After that, you'll see that we have pictures of each of the characters. We have Peter, we have the bird, we have the duck, the cat, Grandpa, and the hunters. So the first thing you have to do is draw a line from the character over to whatever instrument that represents the character. It may be the flute, which is really, really high, or the string quartet, or maybe the bassoon, which is really, really low, or the kettle drums, maybe the clarinet, or also the oboe. Those are your choices. All you have to do is draw a line from the character over to whatever instrument that represents the character, and the movie's going to help you figure that out. After you draw that line, you need to decide whether that instrument is making a high sound or a low sound. And then if it makes a high sound, you're going to circle the word high. If it makes a low sound, you're going to circle the word low. I'm sure that the subject can help you out if you have any questions. So make sure that you listen very closely to the movie. Listen very closely to the music that's playing. And also make sure you listen to the substitute, because the substitute is going to give you some instructions. It's going to make the class even more fun. So thank you very much. Behave yourselves, and I'll see you next week. Bye.
This is a Disneyland original little long-playing record, and I am your story reader. I'm going to begin now to read the story of Peter and the Wolf. You can read along with me in your book. So as not to spoil your enjoyment of the music, which runs right through this story, there are no bells when we reach the end of each page. Let's begin now. This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. Now, as you know, in the musical score of Peter and the Wolf, each character is represented by an instrument in the orchestra. Peter is represented by the string quartet. And his trusty pop gun by a pop. The bird, whose name is Sasha, by a flute, which plays very, very high. Sonia the duck by an oboe, like this. And here is Ivan the cat. He is represented by a clarinet in a very low key. Grandpa is an old bassoon. When the hunters shoot their guns, we hear the kettle drums. And there is also a wolf. Little did that old wolf know what was in store for him. One day our hero, little Peter, armed with his pop gun, set forth to capture him. However, Peter's grandpapa didn't think little boys should go hunting wolves, so Peter, the great hunter, who was almost 6 years old, was carried back into the cabin. Peter still dreamed of hunting, though, and when his grandpapa fell fast asleep, he slipped out. He went out of the cabin, across the snow, and into the dark forest. He was very happy. Peter met Sasha, the little bird.
May I go hunting too?
He asked. Then Sonia the duck came along. Sonia kept thinking she saw the wolf when he wasn't there. Ivan the cat joined them too. Then Ivan started arguing with Sasha. They made a lot of noise.
Stop it! Stop it! Said Peter. Ivan, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Sasha, Ivan's sorry. He won't do it again. Everybody calmed down and began hunting the wolf once more. Watching the squabble from behind some trees. Suddenly he darted out and began to chase Sonia. Thank you.
little duck was so frightened that she ran back and forth from this side to that, trying to get away. The others tried to help.
Over there! Run for the hollow tree!
Poor Sonia. She couldn't run fast enough. A little green feather floated down to the snow, and that was all her friends could find of her. This crime go unpunished? Not if Peter and Sasha could help it. Peter quickly made a lasso with his rope, and Sasha threw it over a branch of a tree. Peter climbed up onto the branch and held on tightly to the other end of the rope. They didn't have long to wait. Soon the wolf came rushing into the clearing. He was in a hurry and didn't notice Peter's rope, and before the wolf knew what had happened, Peter had caught him by the tail and was holding on for dear life. The wolf put up a mighty struggle, snapping his big teeth at Sasha, who fluttered around trying to help Peter, who was pulling hard on the rope. Sasha got so excited, he even bumped into the tree. The rope, sawing back and forth against the branch, began to fray.
"Fly, Sasha! Fly for help!" called Peter.
And Sasha flew as if Peter's life depended on it. Just when things were looking their blackest, Peter heard a hunting horn and looked down. It was the hunters, Misha, Yasha, and Guadimir. Sasha had brought help at last. By the time Sasha and the hunters reached Peter, he and Ivan already had the wolf tied up. So Peter was a hero, and Ivan was a hero, and they were safe. They tied the wolf to a pole and paraded him through the town, and all the villagers cheered. Sasha wasn't happy, though. He was thinking of Sonia, his lost playmate. But when he went back to the hollow tree, there was Sonia, who had hidden inside and was safe after all. So now Peter could go hunting whenever he wanted to, and everybody lived happily ever after. Everybody, that is, except the wolf.